Welcome back to the channel, everybody. Today we are working on the Minneapolis Moline. It's been, I know, a long time, but it's been freezing cold in here because I don't have heat on this side of the shed. And got the rings for the cylinder, or for the piston that was stuck, got that pulled out, took a hydraulic press to rip that out of there. And then I cleaned up the cylinder, which it didn't do too much damage, but cleaned it up anyways. And then I just got the rings installed. They're good. Made sure the gap was good. Now I'm gonna install this cylinder because this has been apart. No, this was all put together, but I had to rip it apart. So I'm gonna get that thrown back on, and I'm pretty sure I have everything here in this mess to get this thing running today, which would be sweet because then I can move that over to the other side there where the snowmobiles and stuff are, and then I can start working on the transmission and that thing, which it's not too bad. It's just the case is cracked in the bottom, but I gotta see what that route is, and that's pretty old, so it's kind of hard to find parts on that. So let's jump right into it, guys, and let's get this thing running today. So got the cylinder on there. It's pretty easy to put on. Just had to make sure it was on there good and didn't rip the gasket. So now we're gonna get the pistons on the crank, or the crank, a piston right on the crank, get everything torqued down there, and then work on the cam and stuff and make sure everything's greased, all the bearings are in there, everything's torqued down, throw the exhaust on, and then I'm gonna do just a gas tank and gravity feed gas into it and see if we can get it started, because I'm working on the fuel tank because the paint didn't turn out too well. So we're close though. Let's jump right into this, get those parts in there, and get this thing moving along. So we got everything in here. That's what I've been working on the last 10 minutes. Just getting all the piston rods connected down here. Put the bearings in, grease the bearings. Got all these connected. These were already connected. Now I had to connect all these, and it's really hard to get in here with all those tight crevices and crap. So now I'm gonna torque each one and make sure it's good. There's a little washer and pin that goes through these. So I'm gonna do that, and then I have to work up here, get everything installed up here, and then gaskets, covers, oil, and we should be good to start it. We got everything on there and torqued down, guys. So we got all the washer on, the pins, everything's torqued, the crank. We got all these in and torqued down. So I'm gonna throw the side cover on here, gaskets and side cover for those, the exhaust on top, the water pump, tighten that belt over here, and figure out what the needs for fluids and some gas and start it right up. So let's do it. Black back, guys. So I got a lot of it back together. I just gotta clean this up. This is where it was stuck, and I was trying to press grease in to get it freed up, but made a mess. But got everything else on. Gotta pull the starter off because I gotta make sure this hole's lined up so it doesn't spin when I engage it. And then I gotta run probably some new electrical line or new electrical for the lights and stuff, just because this is all just hacked together. My connections were just taped, so I'm gonna do it right and get that done. But otherwise, got this all back together. The only thing that's missing is the hood, vent, and gas tank. Otherwise, this looks pretty good. I'll also do some touch-up paint where took the bolts off because it nicked it up pretty bad. But otherwise, looks awesome. Let's see if she'll start.